I published this circuit 10 days ago or so, but it had a flaw. So I hope that this video gives a good insight and the flaw is no longer there. It's a siren generator, a two-tone horn, police siren circuit, and it consists of two non-stable multivibrators. The first is visible here, and the second is visible here. This is the generator for the tone, and this is the clock generator. Both are in fact the same circuits. The capacitor here and this resistor sets the time-dependent period during which the circuit switches. So this is a very high value capacitor. This results in a low frequency. Here we have two low frequency capacitors, and this results in the typical tone, the siren tone. Where it generates exactly, I don't know, but it works properly. And I want to demonstrate it now. I connect here the clock to the siren circuit, and via this resistor here, DC, I drive the siren by changing the voltage here between the base from the second transistor, this transistor, the BD139, and the ground. Switch on the power now. 12 volts. And when we connect the crocodile clip to another part of the clock circuit, we get a different sound. So what I'm going to demonstrate now is at first connection here and then to this location from the circuit. Now to the third point from the circuit, and that's this location here. And this is what we see on the scope now. And when I turn the potentiometer, there will also be different sounds. I do that now. Turn the potentiometer. Turn it back. Again to the other location. Turn the potentiometer again. So you can set all kinds of sound effects. Again to the first location. Turn the potentiometer again. And you can change both the frequency by changing these capacitors. These two capacitors, when you change them, the siren tone changes. These two, and the clock frequency can be changed by changing the value from this capacitor or that capacitor. So when you bridge this capacitor with another 47 microfarad capacitor, the clock switches in another period, a long period and a short period. And here this is exactly the same when you change the values from these two capacitors. Also here we have a longer high tone or a longer low tone, and you can also change very easily the frequency by changing the value from this resistor or that resistor. It's now 27k here and 10k here, but when you make it for instance 100k, you will hear a completely different sound. And finally, one funny thing. When you connect another multivibrator circuit via a capacitor to parts of this circuit, you will hear very peculiar sounds. So the new frequency is added in a certain way to the siren circuit. So very typical tones can be produced with the circuit. One demonstration again, when it wants to work. Where's my positive lead? No, I can find a positive lead, but this is the whole circuit. I've used here a BD139 as a driver transistor for the loudspeaker, and to get the frequency stable, I've used this circuit. It's a classical voltage stabilizer circuit with a 7805, and then we have a very precise 5 volt here at the output, and that means that the tone from the siren doesn't change due to voltage differences, supply voltage differences. So that's a good way to stabilize the tones from the siren.